shit.
Grotto.
Light and you know, just missed him. You throw rocks at him, just missed him. So I went and got a pellet gun. Channel 3?
Don't worry, you're not being taped.
Sweet. So I can do this?
You can totally do that.
What do you think of that?
What's that?
What's your take on Gary?
Well, I think it's summed up best in his motto, which was, you don't have to be hungry to eat a donut. That was, yeah.
Your favorite quote of the day?
That was a good one, yeah. We're going to get a license plate for him. I thought it was appropriate.
Pretty nice. What's your favorite thing about Friedland Hydro Seating?
Days off.
What's the worst thing?
Just kidding. Are you seriously taping me?
No. I'm trying to get the colors right.
Yeah, right. A little red flashing dot.
No, that means it's recharging. There it is. What you discovered?
Two are under a couple ounces. Of...
Hey, more cushion, more pushing.
Oh, wow, that's cool. Looks like my eyeball zooming in and out.
As long as I can still hit
you, can see it zooming in.
Yeah. Is that in?
Yeah.
Keep my nose. Sweet. Gary's the greatest guy I've ever met. He's one of those type of guys. Oh, you're not filming.
Lovely. Attacking on you guys, yeah.
So who's taking this?
I don't know. You got five guys working with you, I don't know.
This is your truck.
This ain't my truck.
Idiots.
Like, it's merge. I don't exactly. Slow down, you do.
Yeah, exactly. You either speed up or slow down. Alright, I'm gonna go there and pretend like I'm earning my money.
You got the guy guys. Could have screwed him, but he was nice.
I know, I just hate that truck, man. It feels like 43 miles.
It is a piece. Super slug.
What is it a piece of, Gary?
It's a piece of Troy. And I mean, that's about the worst thing you can ever imagine. Is that yours? That's pretty nice.
This would be really sweet for me. But... guy wants me to make sure I blow off these gravel roads real quick. I told him, yeah, I'll do the best I can. You know, they're trying to set grade. You put organics, this. I mean, you get organics in this. When you put the asphalt on it, eventually the organics decompose and then you get sinkholes and stuff.
Oops.
So, you know, when you see roads that have big holes in them and put the cart before the horse, the key to a really good road is this. If this is right, everything's right.
We just tacked
just the side where the wind's blowing with us, so we didn't get your shit off.
I just jumping around. I'm sorry. I got a little bit left there.
It actually worked good the way you jumped around, so then we can tack while you're starting.
Well,
I'm
jumping, trying to make the wind work in the direction we're going, so they're not eating it.
Yeah.
I wish I could.
No, this is the problem, is when we leave after a day of straw, you don't feel like driving home in there.
That's all we got.
We were supposed to go do that other spot. I don't even know if I'll finish here with this.
What other spot?
One street down, there's a collection thing or something.
I know seating's not as hard, but we've gotten stuck with so much hose this year.
You guys have had all the garbage,
We paid some serious dues.
No, it was Timmy did that too.
guys ever did that engine? Everybody off.
Is he pissing you off a lot?
He just seems like he does things over and over again that he knows is going to irritate people. And he does it and then he kind of snickers at it like, you know, it's a joke, you know?
I think he's kind of thick-headed.
Well, I get kind of tired of it, man, but I'll tell you what. Tony's got a short fuse.
Yeah.
Tony's been, you know, about a half a step away from cleaning his clock more than once. I think Elgin thinks because Tony's a witness that he's not going to hit him, man. Tony's
biggest shortcoming is...
Oh, don't do that.
I think Elgin is a good soccer face.
I don't know what it is, man. Sometimes I think he doesn't do it from the corner. Because Pete's strong. I mean, he's big, bulky, and strong, and Elgin tries to do it the same way that Pete does it, and he drops a lot of bales off the truck.
Yeah, he's telling me he's dropping bales.
He drops, you know, probably four times as much as anybody else, but I don't know if Pete, but Tony and Adam won't pick him up for him anymore. They just stop and make him get down, pick it up, get back around, because usually the guy cutting strings will grab him, you know?
Yeah.
But they're just... I don't know. I mean, I'm not the one working on the bed, so I don't know, man. That's hard work.
See, this year, it's like, I didn't get all the way to the curb, to the sidewalk.
I mean, I don't even worry about it, man.
It is covered, but I'm trying not to hit the sidewalk. It's a little lighter here than.
I don't think it's going to matter. This is rice, anyway. That's meat there.
What was that stuff you guys blew this morning at,
And
rice. That stuff was fluff, man.
That's what this is over here.
This stuff is really fluffy.
It's rice.
You guys blew this up thick there too, huh?
I don't know, man. He's blowing it from the hill. And...
Oh, okay, yeah.
It's going to be a pretty good size. It's not going to be as big as Dublin. Damn, I just can't get this. But right now, it's just a little nothing. And they're cutting trees out with these really cool... I mean, they're like excavators with big saw blades on the end of them. There's one guy, they're pulling all the dead bushes and trees down this hill, and they're blocking the only road in, so he's got a big pile there.
Said.
What time is it? About 5:30.
Yeah. And you guys only put two loads down in that big flat area, and I'm gonna have to put three down to cover it. So I'm gonna need, you know, you guys are two loads ahead of us, which means I need about, I'm about three or four tack loads behind you guys already, and that's about close to 3 hours worth of work. So as it is, I'm probably going to be spraying into the wee hours of the night already.
Okay, this is the fourth load that we sprayed here. We've done four loads of 120. So what you're saying is, if we stop at the end of this load, you're still going to have to work after dark?
What time does it get dark?
Well, look at the sun, man. It's probably got a good hour.
Yeah. We, at our best, we cover a load to yours, and I have one more load down there in the flat, so that's a load there, and then I have two other loads to cover the two loads that you've done besides that, that slope over there and then this flat area. So that's about, I'd say, 2 hours, 2.5 hours worth of work. So like,
go over these binder bags twice?
Yeah.